Hey, what's good, y'all? Say to said the Wolfman. Ain't did a voiceover in a while. Well, here goes one. I'm doing it over the gun videos. Got a couple of them, so let me tell you what's happening. My homegirl Jim is new in Texas. She just got here from Minnesota, and she's never fired a gun like these before. She's fired pistols, but she's never fired AKs. And she was dealing with cabin fever, which we all are in a sense. So I was like, hey, you know what? Let's go out and shoot AKs. Now, I met Jen in the gym at the vault. She used to train at the vault before the pandemic hit. So she moved to Texas, and we lifted weights. We lifted weights once. Then Eliana came, so I was away from the gym. Then the pandemic hit. But we stayed in touch because she's dope when it comes to lifting weights. But she wanted to hang out, and I was like, look, hey, we'll go to the gun range, and I'll show you some things. So let me tell you what's going on here. I told her, you know, to rack it hard, but she didn't rack it hard. And what ended up happening is we got an insufficient indent on that round. So Jen is real... This is probably one of the good things about her from lifting weights is she's really coachable. So I told her everything. I was like, hey, put it back on safety, and went over the whole entire thing as far as gun safety is controlled. It's being told basically. Yeah, told her that's how you rack it like that. But yeah, I'm taking a look at that round. I see that indent. I'm like, all right, we're gonna check about that later. But she is very coachable. And one thing that is really dope about her is she is not timid or scared at all when it comes to guns.
It's all safety, but it's ready to go.
Telling her to now aim for the center mass or the middle of the paper target and put some shots in there. And she did. She's dope. Got her feeling comfortable with the 103, so we put the target back at 15 yards. Let her rip on that real fast. All right, let me get a disclaimer on hybrid right here, because it's something to be said. So this is the second time that I brought this gun to shoot, and this gun is brand new, not broken in, and also I have not oiled the gun. So it was giving me some problems where it was double feeding, and it ended up the cartridge on that double feed, and I ended up putting it back into the magazine and giving it to the 103 and the 103 80. But so at first, I'm thinking, all right, man, I spent a really good grip of money on this gun, and it is not holding up to the end of the damn bargain that I got it for. I may not buy another one. As of today, the hybrid runs really good. It runs really fucking good. And the whole reason why I brought it with Jen to shoot was because it's a soft shooting gun. You can see how the recoil is with her. It doesn't really just push her back as much. Now, she's able to control the recoil a lot better now that she's getting used to shooting these AKs, the AK variant gun. But yeah, that 103 is really good. That hybrid is really good. At first, I probably just said some bad things about it. But I got Jen shooting 25 yards now, and she is putting the rounds in the middle of the target like she's supposed to. She is killing this shit. She is dope with the 103, and she is also thinking about getting herself a 103 after shooting these guns off that time we went out. I got the Scorpion out, shooting a 9, and I figured that it'll be another good gun for her to try since this is a pistol and it's compact. So I figured, all right, well, you know, she got some AKs, let her shoot this sub gun compact version, see how she felt with it. So I brought that out and let her take a run on it. Told her how to take care of this gun. She's, hey, look, Jen is better than some of you dudes out there shooting guns. We'll just put that out there right now. Asked about it, and she says she likes the 103 over the Scorpion, and that's saying a lot because everybody loves the Scorpion. Everybody loves the Scorpion. As a matter of fact, everybody who has shot a Scorpion loves a Scorpion, and everybody who has not shot a Scorpion loves a Scorpion. Those same people won't like an AK, and they probably don't like an AK, and they haven't even shot one. Jen is like, this 103 is dope. I said, hey, go ahead and fit this out the mag. And like, I hope that she gets one soon. And, you know, I might as well send her a text message whenever one comes available so she can go ahead and purchase it. But she had a good time. I'm glad that I was able to show her the AK world, the gun world of AKs. And you know what I'm saying? Hopefully she'll be at the range on her own one day. And like I said, so the hybrid is no longer having that problem. So you can just X all that shit that you just saw right there. And in future videos, you'll see that hybrid is not only running good, but running fine. All right, so here's another day me and the homie Nate came out. Now, this is my brand new KS-47 pistol, which I have named Dolomite. Okay. Couple of things. Well, hold on. Let me get a couple shots off. You know what I'm saying? No shots fired, huh? All right, so let me tell you something. So, a couple things. So, when I bought the KS-47, I didn't look on the website. And on the website, it specifically says what magazines work in this gun. And this is a US Palm magazine. And you can see when I try to shoot it, the magazine just unlocks. But this is one of the magazines that they said does not work in the gun. Also, I heard people say that the Palm magazines are not really good in running in any kind of gun, but it's ran in other guns. Watch the magazine while I shoot this. Watch what happens. It unlocks. So I'm having this problem with multiple magazines. And even some of them, they're not even going in. But like I said, I didn't read the website, which they said which magazines work and which ones don't work. Now, I ended up taking this gun back to Palmetto because I figured that this was a problem, and Palmetto gives you 100% lifetime warranty. They checked it out, said everything was fine, which I thought was weird. And also I was worried because I had this on this before I got to the range. I had already bought a 16-inch KS-47 named Wolverine. And so I'm worried, I'm like, man, am I going to have this problem with both of these guns where this shit's not going to work like that? Well, since then, got the gun back from Palmetto and it works. Now, they said there wasn't a problem with the gun. Watch this, man. Fucking comedy hour. They said there wasn't a problem with the gun at all. You just got to load it properly. I'll tell you this. When I load it now, the mag release button is looser. Before, on both of the KS-47s, they were very, very, very tight. Very tight. And at one point, if you will lock it in hard, where basically, just like a regular AK magazine, you lock it and then you rock it. And if you rock it and then it didn't make the mag release touch the trigger guard. So what I would do is I would push the trigger guard all the way back, and that bitch would lock and then would not allow you to take it out. I had to take a rubber mallet, a rubber hammer to the mag release to end up getting it out. Now that I've ran the 16-inch, it's looser and it works fine. And this one's, now that it's came back from Palmetto, it's working fine. So everything works now. Everything works. Hey, so this is a little baby ARV 9mm, takes Scorpion magazines. I got a little story on this one as well, but let me get to my pride and joy for this day, which is this beautiful AKV. Oh man, so oof. Oh, this thing is fucking beautiful. First off, brand new gun, haven't shot it yet, and I'm having problems trying to load the magazine. I'm shoving it in there and it's not wanting to stay in there. Finally got the thing in there, but I've named this one Olive Oil. This one has the ALG trigger on it, and hey, let me let you just check this thing out. What the fuck, right? Same things. You see the magazine just, if you watch it again, you'll see that magazine just dip out just a little bit. So I really don't understand. Now this was, and I think this is because it's brand new, because after running these shots, I never had this problem anymore, but I couldn't get the fucking magazine in. I could not get that bitch to sit in there at all. I did not understand it. So I'm shoving the hole in there. It's not clicking, but we finally get it in. I finally get it in there eventually, and it works as a dream. Now, let me go back to ARV, Lil Baby. So the original one that I wanted had a brace on it, but it was sold out by the time I was ready to make a purchase. So I kind of rage bought the one that you see there, the Lil Baby, without the brace. So on the way while it's being delivered, I buy a shockwave brace from Strike. So I get Lil Baby in, and lo and behold, it has a rifle buffer on. Not a pistol buffer, but a rifle buffer on. And it's like, are y'all trying to force me to SBR the motherfucker? What the fuck? You know what I'm saying? Look at me, still struggling trying to put magazines in. I finally get this one. I think I get this one in. But this is an ETS mag. Funny story on this. On one of those magazines, I ended up having Nate shoot it, and it actually exploded on him. The bottom came out. Weird shit. I guess it just doesn't like bags or something. So with Lil Baby, yeah, brand new gun, didn't oil, and as of today, olive oil works flawlessly. But hey, brand new shit. Shit happens like this. But so with Lil Baby. I'm a little upset because I got a rifle buffer on the pistol, and I'm thinking, man, I'm not about to SBR the motherfucker. So I hit up Strike. Strike says we got a pistol buffer that you can put on there. Buy the pistol buffer, put the I'm gonna tell you also, after shooting the gun, I didn't really like it. It wasn't like I hated it, but I was just like, I'm not too thrilled about it. Doesn't really thrill me. Doesn't really do anything for me. After I put the pistol buffer on and put the shockwave brace on, I fucking love Lil Baby. Lil Baby is now my truck gun, because it is something that I can easily move in and out of a backpack. It's 4 inches long, so I can move it back and forth without hitting anything. Oh yeah, Lil Baby is dope. It's the shit. I love that fucking gun.
What brings you?
Brand new build. This is Scorpion Op, another seasoned Scorpion that I bought, and I built this before shooting it. So in this, look at me doing the RoboCop. That's the RoboCop. You say if you ever watched the RoboCop, that's when he does it. You know, he's in his shit. He shoots with one hand like that to the side. So I felt, you know, I was in my bag too, so I felt like that. But things I put in that is kind of similar to Scorpion. I have HBI spring, and I have Strike. I have the Strike pistol grip and HBI safety, ambidextrous safety. That optic I have on there is a fire fill, and that shit failed twice. So that's why I'm looking through the glass, because when I'm shooting it, it turns off. So that's why I turned the laser on and started firing from the hip. Back of Dolomite, and I'm trying to do some troubleshooting. So I'm thinking, okay, maybe if I hold the mag while I shoot, maybe that'll keep things going. And it works. It works a little bit. Now that palm mag doesn't like it. At this point, it stops feeding on this magazine. So that was really everything I could do to try and get that shit to work. And I'm like, all right, well, if it's not gonna feed, it ain't gonna work. It ain't gonna work. You know what I'm saying? Look, you see? I don't know what's going on. So my cool thing is Palmetto, and this is why I have so much Palmetto shit, is that they back everything lifetime warranty. So I felt pretty satisfied thinking that they're gonna take care of me on doing any repairs or replacements if needed. So I got it going now with the magazine release being looser. I don't know if it's just a break-in period with shooting these guns, but on this one, which is an 8.5, and the new one that I have, which is a 16-inch, they don't have these problems anymore, and I'm glad. But I put in this P-Mag, and I hold it down, and finish out a magazine the whole entire time, and got some good flames. Now that I got Dolomite running well, running good, and I also gotta say this, even just a little bit there that I did get to shoot, it is very accurate as it is. So I want to run that against my Draco Black Panther, just to see, okay, now that they're about the same size, same length, let's see who's better at accurate at speed. All right, so back with Lil Baby again. This is one of the other reasons why at first I really wasn't feeling Lil Baby. I was having the same problem with these Scorpion magazines in Lil Baby as I was with Olive Oil, the AKV. That because they're brand new, everything's brand new in these motherfuckers. So it's just not feeding the magazines at first. And I'm like, I mean, do I gotta hold the bolt open to get this thing to feed in there? Like what's really going on? This is some problems. And it's embarrassing. I'm like, you know what I'm saying? You over at the gun range and you trying to do all this extra shit? Hey, but it got in there. So now, at this point, Olive Oil is the star of the range right now, killing it. Yeah, with the LG trigger on this thing, and the weight balance that this thing has, it's a monster. Olive Oil is so sexy, and I love Olive Oil so much, I bought another one that same day, and It doesn't have the LG trigger in it, but it's still fun, and it's still a really good platform. I never really liked 9mm until I started shooting these type of carbines, subguns. I wasn't a fan of 9mm. I was always in that mode of you need to have 45 or 40 or something in order to really put down somebody. But hey, no, these nines can go, and they go. Hey, so at this point, little baby is broken in pretty fast, but broken in and ready to go like she's supposed to. Get that last round out of the chamber. I just so happen to have Scorpion with me, which is my original CZ Scorpion, the first one that I bought. This one I have the HBI Industries spring trigger and safety on here with the Strike Industries grip and goon tape. Had the homie Nat come through, had him shoot Scorpion. Out of all of them, he likes Olive Oil, the AKV, the best. I don't blame him, but he likes Scorpion. He felt that the way Scorpion shot without a brace was still legit. But as of now, Scorpion is braced up. I no longer have that Firefield optic on there. I got an EOTech on there. He thought the optic worked fine. I'm like, I don't know what you saw, man. That optic was crap. Should not have bought that.
Like that. Even without shouldering it, it's like
exactly.
Well, looking at the time, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up. Everything shot pretty good now. As a matter of fact, I should say that as of now, everything shoots without problem. Some guns have changed. They don't look the same. So just subscribe and you'll see how everything else is looking, how everything else is shooting, and probably some friendly competition coming up between me and Nate and maybe some other folks. Hey, avoid the felony. Don't talk to cops. Yep. Yeah.